Hi, my name is Cameron, and I'm the content lead here at Tinybird. In this screencast, I'm going to walk you through a very basic Tinybird workflow from ingestion to endpoint. Now, there's a lot more to Tinybird than what you're going to see in the next 3 minutes, but if you're new to Tinybird, this is a great place to start. Let's jump in. First, navigate to ui.tinybird.co in your browser. You can create a Tinybird account if you haven't already, or log in if you have. Let's start by setting up your first workspace. Workspaces are collaborative environments where you build, iterate, and deploy your Tinybird data projects. Your first task is to select the region for your workspace. This is where your data is stored, so pick the region that makes the most sense for you. I'm based in Nashville, Tennessee, and I expect that my users will also be in the US, so I'm choosing US East. Keep in mind, you can have workspaces in more than one region. After you pick a region, you can now create your first workspace. Give it a name and optionally select a starter kit if you don't want to start from scratch. For this one, let's go with an empty workspace. And now you've got your first Tinybird workspace set up and ready to roll. Step one is to add a data source. So click the plus icon next to data sources in the left nav. There are several options for ingesting data from streams, files, databases, and more, but let's start with a sample data source. Click remote URL up top and copy the example curl command, which will issue a post request to the Tinybird data sources API using your admin token to create a new data source from a remote CSV file containing stock prices. So paste that curl into your shell and run it. Now you have a data source. Step two is to create a pipe. So click create pipe. In Tinybird, a pipe is a series of chained composable SQL nodes. You can write simple SQL statements in a node, and each subsequent node can query over the results from prior nodes. This way you can avoid massive nested CTEs and just go fast. Here's an example. Let's query that data source you just added to get the top 10 stocks by total trade volume in the year 2007. Let's name this node top 10 trade volume. Now, let's scroll down to create a new node and write a query that gets the maximum stock price in that year for each of those top 10 stocks returned by the prior node. And there you go. That's a very basic Tinybird pipe. The final step in this workflow is to turn that node into an API. So give it a name and then in the upper right-hand corner, click Create API Endpoint and select that final node. Boom, endpoint created. Now test it out. There are several options out of the box for this endpoint, but the default here is just HTTP JSON. Copy the endpoint URL, open a new browser tab, paste it, and enter. There's your response, packaged in JSON. And that's it, a very basic Tinybird workflow in about 3 minutes. Now, you might be wondering if the UI is the primary or even only way to interact with Tinybird. And of course, the answer is no. In the next screencast, I'll talk all about the CLI and how to use it to push your Tinybird data projects to production. See you there.